Nobody's ever gone broke selling paranoia. Welcome to hour 15 of my one-year anniversary drunk marathon. You know, with me, every marathon's a drunk marathon. I'll tell you, man, Kim is going through it. I'm glad she has a paralegal, finally. She needs minions. She needs a junior partner. Because just the scale of this work is fucking overwhelming, man. Like, holy shit. I assume, I guess it's a dangerous assumption. Let me tell you what I was going to say, and then I'll modify it. I was going to say, I assume that you can copy-paste it once you get the first job done. Then you can kind of copy-paste it. Obviously, you have to modify it, depending on the area. But then that's a dangerous assumption, because different states have different requirements. Hell, different counties have different requirements. You might almost just have to do it from the ground up again. Every time. That's a lot of fucking work. This motherfucker had models for days, man. His model makers, he must have 5 or 6 model makers putting all that shit together. So, she's going through it. I got a bad feeling, man. Like, she's the new character who's my favorite. I have a lot of favorites from the old characters, but she's my, I'm sure this isn't new. This is probably everybody feels this way. But man, I'm really, really, because I understand, because my whole life is work. That's all I do is work. You know, I'm probably putting in 10, 12 hours a day. And so, and I enjoy it. I enjoy the work. But I'm a fucking workaholic. I always have been, no matter what I was doing. Back when I was doing architecture, filmmaking, I just enjoy the work, and it's all I, you know. So I get the pressure. I get the feeling like sometimes you're in over your head, you know. And so that's probably why I relate to her so much. All right, well, let's see if Jimmy's still making her cry, fucking asshole. Who's putting in the work today, do you think? It ain't Nacho, because he's fucked up. Maybe it's a flashback. I wouldn't have guessed him. It didn't seem like he's far back enough. Okay, so I predict at the end of this episode, he's going to say some shit that's going to blow their fucking minds. And that'll be the last thing he says before the end of the episode. I've been here before. The Ozarks come to mind. The reason I wouldn't have guessed him is it felt like, you know, maybe I'm being an asshole, but it felt like the car design wasn't old enough, you know, back in the past far enough for him to be a kid. Because that dude is old, man. He's fucking old. Plus, this is 2004. It's not 16 years on, right? Now somebody being that old, that would make sense, right? You know who we haven't seen the two guys that Tuco had in Breaking Bad? The big boy and the shit talker who got his ass beat to death? We haven't seen those two guys.
Interested, we'd like to offer you a position at our uptown branch.
Oh, this is the cell phone store?
Yeah. I'd rather do crime. Sorry.
You should talk to someone. Yeah, I got a name.
Her name is Dr. Melfi. She moved from Jersey. I hear she's great.
Miss Wexler, do you have a matter before the court today?
No, Your Honor, just observing.
You're making me nervous.
All right. Judge Melfi would like to see you in chambers at the next recess. First
place. Like you said, you're making him nervous. Stop looking at him.
And
agreed to
drop. In.
The fuck you want?
I don't want to bother you while you're eating.
Interested?
Of course.
I can't share all the details just yet, but I can give you a broad...
It involves you staying the fuck out of my courtroom.
She goes to the hospital for delivery, and there's a mistake with the anesthesia. She aspirates vomitus into her oxygen mask. The hospital refuses to take responsibility, and they've hired one of the most expensive firms in the state.
HHM?
This is the plot of the verdict.
Yes.
Oh, shit.
Because
I guess I've never seen that. That motherfucker had me going, man. I'm fucking actually mad.
And over a grilled cheese sandwich. This is the real world, Miss Wexler, and you won't find any Save the Broken Lawyer case. Don't be the first to try to rediscover their love of the law by trolling my court.
He recognizes the law sheep when he sees one.
Next time I see you lurking in my court, I'm going to put you to work.
He really, really don't like lawyers sitting in the audience. Get the fuck out.
Thank you.
That is fucking hilarious, man.
by opposing counsel.
She's still there. She's a lawyer with a broken wing. Both figuratively and literally.
Sorry, I'm late.
Hey. Don't tell me he's trying to hit that.
Maybe I could stop by after.
Real?
I see you working it.
You can't know that.
Wrigley Field didn't get lights until 88.
I trust Mike.
There were no night games before then.
Oh, shit.
None of his details add up.
Boy.
Okay. You want to put your money where your mouth is?
Oh, shit.
Well, you going to come to group tonight?
Make it interesting.
All right. $10 says that when he talks about Judy, different story.
All right. You're on.
Well, now I'm interested, too. Micah could be paying out those $10. She's buying breakfast tomorrow, motherfucker. You know, if Slipping Jimmy would trust his first instinct, half the shit in this series wouldn't have happened. He never trusted his first instinct. His first instinct was, fuck this job. He didn't trust it. He will be quitting this fucking job. Trust your first instinct.
When's inventory week?
You just missed it.
Any chance that you could move me to a store with a little more traffic?
You just can't handle being bored, man.
Let's see. If I can, I'll swing by later. Keep up the good work.
Yeah. See you then. Bye.
Most people would love this job, man. Jimmy, like, he just can't sit still. I got a bad feeling about this. But if we're going to knock something over, of course, he would like that. It'd give him some work. I mean, they're going to need a patsy. Apparently, they found their patsy. Oh, they make it look like a local unit. Gotcha. That was smart. These two motherfuckers like, nah, man, we got this. Shit. Shut the hell up. We got this. They're going in right now. Dude, don't play, man. They don't fuck around, man. They are a two-man wrecking crew.
Amigos.
They are not fucking around, man. And probably what it is, like the shit that they stole from him is in the building because they sold it, right? So this is a perfect setup. Man. Flawless. Flawless execution. Jesus fucking Christ, they are not fucking around, man. Yeah, we'll get a crew together. This is like the difference between Star-Lord and Iron Man. These two motherfuckers are Star-Lord. Like, no plan, just roll in. Fuck them, they were drug dealers. At least they were in the game, right? Man, he is fucked up, boy. These are ripping stitches and shit. He's got one shot. They came in kind of half-cocked, that's for damn sure. At least they had their bag full of toys, right? Man, he ripped his goddamn stitches. Motherfucker. Better not be smelling any fucking bile, that's for damn sure. You got your fucking bullets falling on him and shit. These motherfuckers, they got their shit handled. Well, I got one of them anyway. And I helped. I have to feel a little respect to me, people. That little nod of respect. You know? They're reckless, and that's why they died, is because they're reckless. Can somebody give him some meds? I'm like, Jesus, man. I'm talking about the pain take away kindy, you know?
It's territory, isn't it?
Don't ask no questions,
motherfucker. Salamanca's wipe out the...
Anyone else?
Yeah, I got some lies to tell.
Good morning. I made French toast for breakfast, and we talked about the self-pasting...
Somebody in the comments was saying she's a shitty actress. I don't agree, but she's not impressive either. She's kind of in the middle somewhere.
When I was making French toast, his son's name is Maddie.
I'm a dumbass.
It's his favorite.
I thought that was Mike as a kid at the beginning. I thought that was Mike as a kid. Dad explains the card. Okay, now it makes sense. Like, for his age, the cars would have been a lot older for him to be that age. That was his son, Maddie, Mikey. Okay, gotcha. I got lost in the sauce.
Might be painful, but if you ask me, I'd say...
I'm with Mike. Shit doesn't help me. It helps a lot of people and good for them. Like, I'm not disparaging at all. It's just some people, it doesn't help, right? It doesn't help Mike. That's for damn sure. He's about ready to whip this dude's ass, man. Fake motherfucker.
Keep trying to get there. You know, to live in the here and
he'll now. Win this $10 and stuff it up this dude's ass.
Hard.
Ooh, is he rubbing his hand?
Work. I've been avoiding him for the last time. He's wanted to go to Sydney. When it was tight.
Last time it was New Zealand, wasn't it, motherfucker?
Finally, we were going to go.
He can't do it anymore.
Mike, you have something you want to add?
You don't want to hear what I have to say.
Well, then why'd you speak, motherfucker?
She wanted to go to Australia? Last month it was Cuba.
Oh, shit.
Come on, Henry. Let's look at the paper, see if the math works.
Come on, Mike.
I'm getting my $10, motherfucker. She'll pay him, but she won't want to have anything to do with him.
Come on, Sid. You have no shame.
Say it or I'll whip your ass. That's what I thought, bitch. But see, that leads to me. You're out of here, Mike.
All wrapped up in your sad little stories.
Okay, now this is too far. Misery. I was with him right up until that point. You can't judge these people. My thing is, if people find something they need, like, I'm not religious. I don't believe in God. If you believe in God and that helps you get through the day, more fucking power to you, man. Like, I'm jealous. I wish I had that. If these people find comfort in this shit, I wish I had that. Like, you know, in my grief, right? I never begrudge what somebody else gets comfort out of. Never. Because everybody should be able to find comfort in something, right? And what I find comfort in, you won't. So, like, that's what I'm saying. Once he starts judging anybody else who's not lying, he went too far. Don't be an asshole.
No son para juegos.
I will play checkers every now and then, but usually I don't play games.
Tienes que irte.
Ahorita you know the rules of talk? That's always confused me. Say something, motherfucker. You can't just hang up. They're going to call your ass back. They always do that shit in movies, man. Try it. Try it in real life. Call 911 and hang up and see what happens. Man, you have Popo rolling up on, knocking on your door and shit. You know, it's kind of similar. He's bored and Jimmy's bored. Maybe they should be bored together.
We're not done yet.
I got more time to waste because I'm bored. It's hard to believe the store would be this empty all the time.
Here you go.
It's a little light, motherfucker. I'm predicting.
When you do, call the vet.
Yeah?
Yeah. New job. New phone.
Smart man.
You never know who's listening.
Smart man, actually. He's careful and he's honest. You know, if you're going to crime, you want to crime with somebody like that, right? I mean, you still don't know if he's going to roll over on you if you get busted, but hey, that's a problem for another day. The fuck you doing slipping, Jimmy? I feel like I'm carrying Chuck's torch by calling him that. Because Chuck's not around to call him that anymore, right? Which is funny, because I kind of hate Chuck, but like I'm sad he's gone. Fantastic. That was a good idea. That dude gave him an idea, man. Fantastic. Nobody's ever gone broke selling paranoia. Wonder if this is that laundromat.
Do you have something to tell me?
Nacho Varga. I wondered when you were going to get around to this.
You came to me.
So? What now?
Exactly.
You're going to make a move, you better make it.
He's got balls this fucking big, man. He don't give a shit.
But they're not gonna, are they?
they're ready to roll two more. Ask.
So why don't you stop running a game on me and just tell me about the job?
He was gonna try to leverage him with the, you know, I'll kill you unless you kind of leverage, you know. That's how Gus operates. God damn you, cliffhanging motherfuckers! God damn, let me elaborate on this since they just fucking abruptly end the episode and shit. God damn it. Fortunately, there's gonna be another episode, the sequel to this, tomorrow. The regularly scheduled episode, since this is taking place on Sunday. But, anyway. I think what Gus's original plan was, look, you crossed me. Now you need to make it right. You know what I'm saying? That kind of situation where you feel leveraged into, you have to accept the offer, right? When you may not be inclined to do so. Mike saw through that bullshit. Don't bring that bullshit to me. He's got old man money, right? Like, and I don't mean that as like actual money. Like, an old man, he don't give a shit. He ain't got much life left anyway. Like, what the fuck's he got to lose, right? Fuck it. So, you ain't scaring him. These young bucks, they got another 40 years to go, man. Do they really want to do this? It's kind of like what Mike's approach to all this shit, right? Oh, man, this shit's really, really getting good. I'm going to be mad when I get to the end of the season. I got to wait for them to drop the greedy-ass Netflix holding back on us. Drop that shit!